game, but Pittsburgh took it to another level last night. Big Ben threw 5 touchdown passes to 5 different receivers, and he had just 3 incompletions during the game. The Steelers' defense was all over Cam Newton with a pick 6 in the first quarter and 5 sacks. The Steelers have now won 5 straight and are looking up at the Chiefs, Patriots, and Chargers in the AFC. Now take a listen to Big Ben after the game.
It's a good feeling to play a good football team. I mean, we know they're a really good football team, and they came out and drove down the field and scored, and we're like, all right, we're going to, you know, this is what we expected. We got to put up a lot of points, and, you know, we did that. And the defense, they were playing like their hair was on fire, and so it was a lot of fun for all parties involved.
All right, Shannon, how much of a shot do you give Pittsburgh to win the AFC?
They're playing really well right now, Skip. But by any metrics, any analytics, the best they are is the third best team in the AFC. I don't believe, because I've seen Kansas City come to their building and stomp them out. Now, we have yet to see them beat the Patriots in any locale. Now, even if I say they're the third best, now I'm disparaging the Chargers, who's been equally as hot as the Pittsburgh Steelers. So by any stretch, at best I can put them as at third. They might be fourth behind L.A. Chargers. But what we're seeing is not new. Last year in the middle of the season, Skip, they won 8 in a row.
Yeah.
I don't even need my notes. I'm so good with this thing right now.
Really?
Yeah.
You got them just never
the end of the end of 2016, yep. They won 7 in a row. Can you tell the people at home how they ended, Alex? I don't want you to ask Alex. Disappointment. They lost. So all this means nothing to me. Now, they're going to get an opportunity to prove whether or not they're better than the Patriots. Mm-hmm. They play them in December. As I mentioned, Kansas City has already come to their building, put pain on them. So we'll see. I don't worry about their offense. Their offense is as talented and explosive as any offense in all of football. Big Ben is going to the Hall of Fame. 3 500-yard passing games in his career. No other quarterback has more than 1. Mm-hmm. 4 perfect passer rating games. No other quarterback can even come close to that. AB, he's first to second best receiver in all of football. Juju Smith-Schuster is as good a number 2 receiver as you'll find in all of football.
Yep.
They got tight ends, McDonald and Jesse James. James Conner is better than they thought. If anybody told you they thought James Conner would have done this, they'd have taken him in the first round. They didn't. Okay? But he's been unbelievable. There's a good chance Le'Veon's going to come back. If and when he does come back, how much he plays, it's going to come down to the defense. I know they were flying around last night. I mean, T.J. Watt, Bud Dupree. Oh, man. Ironhead, rest his soul, his son. Haywood was getting after him to it. They did an unbelievable job, Skip. That don't mean anything. What you going to do with them old Patriots? What you going to do with them bad boys from New England, from Foxborough?
That bad quarterback.
Well, hold on. That is not your turn. I didn't ask you to respond. It's like a rhetorical. That don't mean you respond. But anyway, I do not believe, as we currently sit here and discuss this topic, they're better than Kansas City. I do not believe that they're better than New England. And if you really force me, my Super Bowl pick, the Chargers, is equal to. So at best case scenario, they can hope to be third. But if you really force me to, I would say probably right now, Skip, they're the fourth best team in the AFC.
You did pretty well without your notes, but I think you need your notes, so I'm going to give it. Because you're going to need your notes for our next discussion.
Oh, so really?
Yeah. So, but I'm going to give you this one. And I'm giving you this one because yesterday at the end of the show, you did pick Pittsburgh to win this game. I gave Carolina a shot because I thought they were rolling just as hot as Pittsburgh was. And that was an utter avalanche. After guess who scored the first touchdown? Carolina went right down the score, and it was 7-0, thanks to little Christian McCaffrey, right?
He played really well.
He's your man.
Yeah.
He played with his father.
Yes.
You watched him grow up.
I did.
And he's grown all the way up, right?
All the way.
Becoming an NFL man. I am with you in general about the Pittsburgh Steelers because I thought back to last year. I remember on a Thursday night, they beat the Titans 40-17 because – every once in a while, it will just be a tour de force of Pittsburgh firepower, aerial circus. Because when Ben is on, is there anybody who can get hotter than he can? I know Patrick Mahomes has shown us things we haven't seen before. But over time, when Ben gets hot, nobody can get hotter. With those weapons?
3 500 passing yard games. No other quarterback has more than one. Oh, wow. He has 3 of those.
And I remember last year they went to the Texans and won 34-6 on a Monday night. And yet they came into this game ninth in the NFL and points scored. Okay, so what? After what you saw last night, could that be the ninth best offense? No. Every once in a while, it's by far the first best offense, but it can be wildly inconsistent because that team at its core has been a troubled football team. Again, James Conner had an okay game. They didn't really need James Conner last night, but he did go into concussion protocol. So how is Le'Veon going to play out? How is that going to impact the psyche of this football team starting, we assume, next Tuesday? Is he coming? Is he not? Is he? I don't know what's going
to
happen.
When he does, how much does he play? Because he ain't coming to sit on no bench.
And how will the locker room accept him after he's been thrown under 18 buses and backed over 24 times by the offensive line?
And guess what? He knows every one of those bus drivers.
He does. He knows all the bus drivers. So what happened this year on opening day at Cleveland? Been through three interceptions and lost two fumbles, and they had six turnovers, and they should have lost to the Cleveland Browns, right?
Yes.
And that was to Tyrod. That wasn't Baker Mayfield. That's Tyrod Taylor and a missed field goal at the end. You know, you know the rest of the story. So back to what you said. 1 year ago on December, this year the game's going to be played on December 16th, but last year on December 17th, it was as usual. It seems like they schedule this every year. Like this is just what happens in the NFL. New England has to go play at Pittsburgh. And in that game, it came down to the last play of the game, and it was third and goal, and there was dissension over the call. That was Todd Haley as the play caller for the Pittsburgh Steelers. Right. Remember, Ben kind of threw him under the bus after the game because he's saying they're yelling in my ear to spike it.
Yes.
And so what did Ben do on that play? If we could see it, he fake spiked it, and then he tried to jam it into Eli Rogers. Why Eli Rogers? I don't even know what he's doing with Eli Rogers. And remember Eric Rowe, who became the quote-unquote hero of the Patriots Super Bowl, right, when he took over the job for Malcolm Butler?
Right.
But he got a hand on the football and tipped it up, and Daron Harmon intercepted it, and that was the ball game. And a couple plays earlier, Jesse James, I thought he scored with the ball. You didn't think he scored with the ball, but it turned on those two plays, right? Yeah. And once again, we both sat back after the game and said, they just can't beat New England. It's a psychological hurdle they just cannot get over. So do you think they can get over it this year? Does this look like the team that could beat them?
Game was, 36-17? Mm-hmm. But it really wasn't that close because they got a touchdown with like a couple of minutes to go. Well, so the game really wasn't that close. They lost last year in the divisional. 45-42.
45-42?
So offensively,
How did you do that?
So we're going to find out. Mm. They're doing all this
thing. So Ben threw last year against Saxonville, he throws for 469, five touchdowns with one interception, and they lose 45-42. And I still don't know how it was. Jacksonville rushed for 164. Mm-hmm. I don't know how they did it. Blake Bortles threw for 214. Mm-hmm. But it was 45-42. Mm-hmm. Well, that's the Steelers. Like there's something sort of rotten to the core where they don't have – like a toughness, some sort of winning mentality that can get them through the toughest
games. Every quarterback that they could possibly face the gauntlet, mm-hmm. you take Phillip Rivers or you're taking Blake Bortles. You're taking Tom Brady or you're taking Blake Bortles. You're taking Patrick Mahomes or you're taking Blake Bortles. Mm-hmm. That's what you're up against. Every one of these offensive got firepower to go hang 40-plus on your defense. So what happened in the Pittsburgh game, that one turnover was the difference in the ball game. One team turned it over, the other team didn't. So this is what you're up against. You turn the ball over probably against one of these teams. Mm-hmm. You're probably going to lose the game.
So can they rush the passer the way they did last night? Because that was hellacious pass rush.
Man,
they were all over Cam.
I thought Cam's offensive line were fans. They bought a ticket to watch the game because they weren't doing their job. That's ridiculous.
I'd never seen anything like that. And Cam hung in for a while, but then he made a horrendous decision.
Yeah, he got to get off that back foot. Again, because what happens if you throw off your back foot, the ball's going to sail. Because he had Greg Olsen.
He had him. And it looked like a tight end screen sort of setup. Yeah,
he had Greg Olsen, but he throws off his back foot, the ball sails. And that's what you're going to get. If they rush the passer like that, they're going to have an opportunity, Skip. But I think that's more of an anomaly than something that we're going to see on a normal occurrence. But we'll find out. That's the thing I love about pro sports, is that you get to prove it. Mm. You get to update your resume. So what you did in 2016, what you did in 2017 is unimportant. Only thing that matters is 2018. So we'll see. We'll see just how great the Steelers are.
I'm still not buying. I'm not completely buying it. I'm with you.
Can I lease?
You could lease a little bit.
Oh, I put it on layaway. Grimmer coming.
Yeah.
I ain't got the money right now to actually buy it.
You fence straddle more than I do. You're like, well, maybe.
I put it on layaway. I might go back and get it. I might not.
Okay. So you got the Steelers on layaway?
Yeah, I got them on layaway.
Really? How much did you put down? Like
$5?
$15.
$15. Yeah.
Wow, okay.
Big spender.
$15 was a lot of money back in the day. You put it on layaway.
You know what it was?
Yeah.
Yep.
Put that thing on, steer the robot.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Well, next up, the Patriots had a big win against the Packers Sunday.